Live from Berklee College of Music in Boston, in snowy Boston, we welcome all of you to this, which is a first, an online webinar hosted through Google Hangouts On Air. And I'm Lee Whitmore. I'm the Vice President for Social Entrepreneurship and Education Outreach here at Berklee. And I have two colleagues with me today, and we're going to focus on some amazing new content in Berklee's Pulse, our pre-university learning system experience. We've got some show and tell. We're going to share some exciting news about something that you can go and use in Pulse today. So in fact, if you are at your computer and want to follow along in Pulse as we work with you today, that's certainly something that you can do. In addition, we are recording this, so you'll be able to watch this back later on our YouTube channel. First, I'm going to just pass the baton. We're going to do some introductions. You've met me. We also have with us Dr. Crystal Banfield, who's the Dean of City Music.
Hi, everybody. How are you?
And we have John Biggis, affectionately known as the Pulse Czar here in the Boston office of Berklee City Music. And John is the person who holds the reins on new content creation and technology for Pulse. So today our agenda is as follows. We will tell you a little bit about a wonderful new initiative that we launched just about a week and a half ago, with our partners in New York City and the New York City Department of Ed. Berklee City Music is connected and supporting a new initiative bringing popular contemporary music education to New York City schools. It's called Amp Up New York City. And we got together with the New York City DOE, with our Amp Up friends, and delivered something brand new in Pulse, specifically for a professional development event that was going on in New York City with a cohort of an amazing set of 70 music educators, certified music educators in the New York City DOE that had their guitars with them. And we're going to tell you a little bit about how that went and what we brought. We created, in partnership with a wonderful filmmaker, Martin Shore, a new unit in Pulse that is focused on rhythm and blues. The content was launched for New York City, and you all can use it. We're in February, which is Black History Month, and I know lots of folks are programming around content, learning materials, activities around Black History Month right now, and so we were able to deliver this in time. The film's called Take Me to the River, produced and directed by Martin Shore. And to just give you a high-level overview about what that is, and then I think we're going to suggest folks take a look at the trailer. And we will provide in the chat window here and the Google Hangout On Air the link for you to be able to watch that. In fact, we can't stream it, so we're going to encourage you to watch it at home, and we'll keep track of time here and come back once it's been able to be played out by you. But here's what the film is about. It's a wonderful connection to American music, culture, history, the lessons and content that we've created with our friends at Take Me to the River. The film include strong connections to the history and culture of music in Memphis and the Mississippi Delta. The film beautifully juxtaposes some greats. So what you'll find is that we've included some greats in our activities in Pulse, thanks to the filmmaker. And the film brings some of the blues and R&B greats from the Delta and Memphis together with some young new artists. The film focuses on that entire history of popular contemporary music in Memphis. It has some very poignant moments about what happened in Memphis around the time of the Civil Rights era, around the assassination of Dr. Martin Luther King, what happened there in a variety of studios. One of them, Stax Records, which now has an academy and a foundation that's benefiting from the proceeds of the film, and happens to be a Berklee City Music partner. We work very closely with them. And so let's take a couple of minutes. If you would, our colleagues here in the control room are going to tee up a link for you. Please take time to click on that link if you're able. Watch the trailer to the film. We'll keep track of the time on that here. And then we'll be back in just a moment or two after you've had a chance to watch the trailer and talk more about what we've created in partnership with this wonderful film. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed the trailer. By the way, this this film, Take Me to the River, was a South by Southwest Film Festival Award winner this year, also won in the UK at the Rain Dance Festival. And it's just absolutely terrific. Our team here has had a chance to view it. It is not a commercial release yet, but for those of you viewing today, we're able to provide a link where you can learn more about the film. In fact, the film, with collaboration tomorrow evening in New York City at the Apollo Theater, the historic Apollo Theater, the filmmaker will in fact launch the education initiative surrounding Take Me to the River. And we, our team here at Berkeley and Berkeley City Music, has contributed to that work. So we'll tell you a little bit about that. And how to find out about the film and how to have access to it so that you can show it to students in, at your school, in your classrooms, in your program, and in your out-of-school time programs as well. So I'm going to turn over the reins on the presentation now, because we want to share with you what we've created: lesson plans, curricular materials, new assets, recordings in Pulse that students and teachers can use, manipulate, that you can use with your students. And so, Crystal, I'm going to turn it your way.
Thank you.
And let's hear a little bit more about what folks can have access to in Pulse.
Okay. Well, as Lee said, we had a wonderful premiere with the public school teachers. We actually had the opportunity to show the whole film, and the response was overwhelming. And really, a lot of the comments that feedback that we got back attributed to the content, the meaning behind the film, what it portrayed, that so many genres came right out of Memphis and that region of the country and has influenced music worldwide. And music continues to flow from there. And so this movie shows that. It brings together these legendary artists and puts them together in what you would call, an intergenerational experience, where they're exchanging and passing on a lot of tradition, rhythm and blues and soul music, the practice, production, there's conversations that are happening. Memphis is right at the crossroads of the Mississippi River, and so it historically has a lot of cultural influences, and the music also embodies a rich tradition of a mixture of races, if you will, at a time when that was not fashionable. And so the teachers at that pilot were just overwhelmed, and so we're excited now to show you some of the materials that they saw so that you can be encouraged too and inspired to share this with your with your students, share it with your peers. There's a lot to learn from, and I'm going to now ask that John kind of walk us through as I talk about it. We have a teacher's guide. The teacher's guide itself is constructed so that if you have a partnership with your classroom, your public school, and there are requirements for those teachers. All of those are there. They're met with the national standards as well as the core arts standards. And there's also frameworks there for assessments too. But there's all kinds of activities and things. We start off with a really brief historical context about Memphis and also about Stax. Stax, the label, as well as the museum now that's there and the academy that exists, of which we're partners with. And then we go right into some activities. We have some film clips so that you can actually see some of the films that are linked to some of the activities. The activities are intended to provide a social cultural context and conversation with a lot of teachers, and conversation with you all who are tuning in, as well as many of the teachers here on campus and even across the country. Sometimes some of those elements that are missed when we're teaching our young people is that social cultural context that helps to inform performance practice. And this movie is perfect for that. It's a documentary, so you're looking at real experiences and a real exchange of ideas and practices. And so that's there, as well as how to teach it. We have some specific music clips that we were able to get, so you have that along with music parts and scores. There's also other activities that we encourage you to partake in that includes doing your own compositions, of course, improvisation. We have note play. We have the tunes that we have featured, a couple from the movie, are also part of our notation mixer, so we encourage you to use that as well. And then also there's a production unit. There's a lot of wonderful clips in the movie where you get to see how unique it is that the music that came out of Memphis and all of those famous just heart and soul pieces, how they actually do the production and how it's recorded in the studio, which is a very unique process. And a lot of young people certainly would not be exposed to, but a lot of people would, I'm sure, be quite interested in that, would help to make that unique sound and flavor that comes out of that. So just looking at some of the pages, I'm going to have John now, based on the technology, to kind of walk you through some of the different, the way we have it organized. It's set up as a class. You go in through the study door and click on Take Me to the River, and you're right there. You can take it away.
Great. Hey, everybody. Are we showing the screen? Okay. So let me take a step backwards.
The question, sorry, folks, from the control room, the question is, are you going to share a screen? So
right.
You're able to, yeah, you should.
Oh, I guess I need to do that, though. Okay, well, let me do that. Pick it out. Aha. Let's share. There we go. That's better. Just to take a step backwards, what Crystal mentioned, just to show you how to get to the content. For those, obviously, you have to log into the Pulse site, and when you do so, you'll see the four Pulse doors. We actually have materials in both the study room and the jam room, but that doesn't matter because the actual course content is all the links you'll need, so you won't have to try to find everything. It will all be right there. So start off by clicking on the study room door, and on the lower left-hand side under the study room units, you'll see a link for Take Me to the River, and we'll click on that, and here we are at the page.
And John, the control room suggests maybe taking that browser window and going closer for all the viewers.
Okay. Well, that wasn't full screen now, was it? Let's see.
Yes.
That better?
Yep.
All right.
Thanks.
That's great.
Sure.
Okay. So here we are at the unit, and the way the unit is divided up is we have the teacher guide, which I'll show you in a minute. We have an introduction, which, as Crystal mentioned, we have five videos that are associated with the movie that are connected. Two of them are in the introduction, and then the other three are in the instructional activities. So I'm just going to click on the introduction. We'll take you to the movie clip. I should play a little bit of this, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and we're going to play a little bit of the first movie clip, which is the intro to the movie itself.
And folks, if you're following along at home or in your classrooms, you can stream this from your desktop and be able to join later in the classroom.
There are special places on this earth. Places of origin. The Mississippi Delta is one of those places. It saw the birth of more musical genres than anywhere else on the planet. An incredible number of musical artists.
Okay.
And again, folks, because John's sharing this through the Google Hangout on Air, we're not expecting the streaming quality to be top-notch. Try it at home later. We're just sharing a little bit of that media so you can get a sense of the fact that it is there. But clearly, everything that we've been able to access thanks to the generosity of the filmmakers and high res, high def, including what you'll see snippets of here and also here over the Hangout on here. But try it at home to have theater quality experience.
Right. And as Crystal mentioned, these movie clips are really wonderful for teaching the intergenerational relationships between the artists and the different styles, and it's really, really a great learning tool. Also in the introduction, we have a little background and history about Stax and the birth of blues in Memphis. So we also have two instructional activities. I don't know if you want to talk a little bit more about this, Crystal. There's an introduction to what these projects are about. There's four projects. They really, you know, you can use them, not use
yeah.
them. It's really up to you, depending on your classroom and who you have for your students. You can choose just a little bit of this, or you can just use the projects really
yeah.
for discussion. You wouldn't even have to do the project, but just sort of, you know, use this as a base of discussion,
yeah.
and then we have more videos to show there.
Yeah. I'll just add, too, that the content is you can use it, of course, as you can, but there's enough there, even how it's segmented and broken out, that you can integrate it into anything that you're doing, just to, again, to continue to bring meaning to what it is that our young people are learning, what they're performing, what they're studying, making it also relative to what they're experiencing today. That's one element that's really significant about R&B and soul music, and that is that there's a meaning behind it. It's really intended to touch the heart and soul.
Right. So instructional activities A and B, both. I think instructional activity B is more of a playing activity, but we have plenty of music content, so we'll get to the music content. Through the generosity of Concord Records, Concord Records has the licenses for the songs in the movies, the stems, which are the tracks that are associated with these songs, and they have generously donated two of them, and actually in the future we hope to add more of these songs from the movie. So what we've done is we've taken these stems and we've created both notation mixer versions of these songs and actually transcribed the parts so you can download them and play them with your ensemble. So let me just show you a little bit of that.
And John, while John's teeing that up, I will mention to everyone, this is a first in our Pulse and a very unique opportunity with the filmmaker and with Concord Music Group, and we thank them. This is the first time that we've had individual tracks and masters, meaning, you know, if there was a Pro Tools session in the studio with these performers and instrumentalists, the filmmaker gave us access in Concord Music Group to the discrete recorded tracks by the vocalist, drummers, guitar player, bass player, you name it. And John will show you a little bit now about what that means. It's pretty incredible.
Right. So what you're about to see here is one of the performances from the movie, Bobby Blue Bland, I think one of his final performances, with Yo Gotti, a rapper from Memphis. And let me just play a little bit of that.
Yeah. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness when she's away now. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. She's always gone to run. Any time she goes away. You do it, you got it.
So if you've used the notation mixer in the past, you sort of know how this works. We have all of the parts from this song all transcribed and individual, so you can use this for study, or if your students want to play with the songs, they can use either the notation mixer or download the content right from the course. So I click on, oh, let me just go back. So I know I tend to do this stuff too fast. So under related Pulse activities, notation mixers and sheet music. I went to Ain't No Sunshine, and down here's the downloadable sheet music, and then you can download the parts for either your ensemble or just the transcribed parts to learn more. One of the special things we did with the Mabel Staples song, Pop Staples wrote, Wish I Had Answered, this is also in the movie and really a great scene from the movie, is we hired George Russell Jr., who was a Berkeley professor, to write a middle school, high school choir arrangement, and it's basically free for your choirs or vocal ensembles to use. I just want to show a little bit. I'm showing the score. There you go. That's a big shot of it. So that's a score of the arrangement that George Russell Jr. created. So your vocal groups have the opportunity to perform this song. Also, we have a notation mixer version of this song as well. Show you a little bit of that.
So, John, I'll just interject with a question. There are some folks who have joined us today that are new to Pulse and have learned about the project, and so they're visiting with us today just to learn a little bit more. For their benefit, can you just, when you say notation mixer, explain a little bit about what that is, just for the novice,
sure. As
you continue to show off what
sure.
you're showing here.
Sure. The notation mixer is one of the primary tools on Pulse that we use for teaching music. And since Pulse began, we've recorded over 90 sound-alikes of various genres, songs of various genres, R&B, hip-hop, rock, blues, jazz. So we record those songs in the studio, so we have all the tracks from those songs. And then in that way we then hire transcribers to transcribe the music, and we have this wonderful vehicle in which to synchronize the music with the notation, and that's what the notation mixer does. It's actually able to synchronize up to 16 tracks of audio with the individual music notation parts. I suppose it might be a great place to add is recently we completed an iOS iPad app version of the notation mixer. So you can now use this if you have a Pulse account. You can now use this on an iPad device.
Wonderful. Can you just, as you start up the this particular tune that you're speaking about, the Staples Singers, Wish I Had Answered, also just give folks a little bit of a tour of the navigation there for those who are new.
Sure.
Just so that they understand what you're clicking on.
Great.
Just for the novice.
So in the upper left, we have the transport. And this is a very powerful program because through keyboard shortcuts, you can easily skip through measures or through rehearsal markers and really get to the parts of the songs that you want to show. You're able to loop the content. So up in the upper left is the transport. It's play and stop. You can rewind and fast forward both measure by measure or by rehearsal mark. And then we have this transport to easily get through the song, so I can just move it.
There. You can make it through.
I can just click and it can basically navigate easily through the song. And this is your measure counter. Here's where you change the different parts to see, now I want to see the bass part. And then I'll play a little bit.
103.
This icon here is the mixer part, hence the name notation mixer, and that's what it actually is. You're able to mix these individual tracks. Mm-hmm. You can solo and mute them, so if your student wants to sing along, let's first of all, we'll solo. That's Mavis Staples on Pulse, folks.
Look at me.
Yeah, let him hear it.
Then in a roll to 104.
I just got chills.
But if you're like me and want to be Mavis, then you'll meet her and you'll sing along and you'll sing. So there you go.
Said I don't believe you will survive.
Awesome stuff.
I love that. That's just amazing. Yeah. Just think about it for all of those of you who are here viewing today. Once you jump into Pulse and use this in your classrooms or in your after-school programs, in your lab, You can even send your students home, and they'll be able to listen to all the discrete parts of these performances, including soloing Mavis and listening to her wonderful vocal, all of that inflection, and just an incredible opportunity and truly a first.
Right. Down here at the question mark, that's where the Pulse manual is, so if you want to learn more about how to use it in depth, you can search that manual. Up here is the ability, like I said, to loop. You can loop by rehearsal markers, you can loop by a single measure. If you want to demonstrate a certain thing about the song, or you just want to practice a part, perhaps your student in a lesson wants to just loop one section, practice, they can do that as well. So,
A couple of questions have come in. We'll continue, but I'm going to direct the first one at Dr. Banfield. And by the way, folks, use your chat window as you're with us in the Google Hangout on air. You can ask questions, and they're passed in through our control room directly to me in order to share with our experts here on the Take Me to the River Pulse content. So to Crystal Banfield, Dr. Banfield, the first question is, age appropriateness for all of this material. Can you just sort of frame up for folks if they jump in, whether they're a middle school or high school teacher or
Grade
elementary?
Sure. It's primarily for middle and high school, but certainly can be used for upper level elementary school students. You know your students. It's written in a way that you can give them exactly whatever their level is, depending on your class. It's also developed so that you can do some collaboration with your social studies teachers. This is a great tool for the social sciences and language arts, given all of the social and cultural history that's present. Also, all of the collaboration that's happening. So there's multiple opportunities for various ages, but it is targeted first for secondary students, level students.
I would say there's a wonderful clip in here of Bobby Blueblatt teaching Lil Peanut how to sing I Got a Woman, and it's really a great thing.
Yeah,
I think
he must
show.
Be about 10.
Yeah,
he's 10. You gotta see it. We caught it. It's a great shot.
Right. And again, to our viewers, if you have questions, tee them up in the chat window, and I'll bring them in as we continue our way through the session. But I think, John, I interrupted you. You were about to show something else in Pulse.
Just to finish, so the teacher guide, if you just want to download the material without, using some of the music, we've created a link. Actually, I can do this. I already have it up somewhere. There it is. So this is just the text that goes along with what's already in the course. It also talks about some of the standards that are associated with that. Even though you may not follow the standards, I think they're really helpful in sort of framing how you might want to teach this curriculum. So they're there for you.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And assessments.
Yep, and assessments.
Also, there's some student learning outcomes as well. Suggested student learning outcomes, so it can make it really easy. We've tried to make it as easy and as accessible for you as possible, so you can make it applicable in your teaching environment as soon as possible.
Right. So if you have access to the movie, but just wanted to show the same clips, you could use this handout to we showed you exactly where in the movie to go to in order to use the material. So there's you can be on Pulse. If you're not on Pulse, you can still use the material.
Let's go. I was going to just reference the matrix. You were in that section there.
I'll just go to this.
We have something called the Extended Learning Matrix. And what I like about this is that while the first several projects are just kind of short so that you can get it going quickly in your classrooms or in your after-school programs, this gives you some ideas to continue to extend learning throughout the rest of the year, anything from using the practical skills unit so that students have the opportunity to do some research, create their own music or get some of the music out of Pulse, and then do their own concerts, and do their own recordings and things. We also, of course, reference Note Flight to use that as well. There's also some suggestions for assessing and doing critiques of concerts and things. Also, thinking about some of those deeper questions in terms of what is call and response and how does that really affect music? How does audience engagement actually impact the music? And you can look and see through the movie what happens when you got the background singers doing all their wonderful singing and how the people who are standing out in the very first couple of clips and how they're responding to it. But what does that feel like when you're in real time and making practice of that? So please be sure to look at that, and then also some of the objectives that we have that will help to support assessment as well.
And John, could you, one of our viewers asked if you could just go back and show specifically where to find that matrix again? Because they missed it when we introduced
it's actually in two spots, so let me show you the easier spot. In fact, this is if you're on the site, you want to use this one. Under related pulse activities, the reason why it's better to use that version is because we've linked some of the material directly. So it says, using Pulse Practical Skills Unit, students will identify these things. So if you just click on that link, it will take you right to the Pulse page in order to do that. So that's the version I recommend that you use.
Fantastic. I've got another question from one of our viewers today, local from Boston. Can you let the audience know, what are the names of all the new songs on Pulse associated with this project, with the film taking the music?
Sure. Well, there's two right now that are out. Because that's all we could handle in a short period of time. And that's okay. We got more on the way. So Wish I Had Answered, which was written by Pop Staples and made famous by the Staples Singers in the movie, sung by Mavis Staples. And Ain't No Sunshine, written by Bill Withers, sung by Bobby Blue Bland and Yo Gotti. We actually have the stems for Knock on Wood in the movie. It's William Bell with Snoop Dogg, I believe.
Yeah.
And the Stax Band,
the Academy.
Right,
yeah.
The Stax Academy. Uh-huh. They're on at least a couple of the songs in the movie, which is really great to see that. And that will be up. That's sort of finished, but we're still kind of working on that.
Yeah. More to come.
More to come, right.
And just quickly show the navigation back to all the tunes in the library, just for folks that are watching and,
sure,
and trying it back, and then we'll switch back to camera for a little bit.
Sure. So there's, just a couple last things I want to show. So
okay.
In the notation mixers that are directly related to both the movie and the Stax music in general, because we had already done six tunes from Stax prior to this. So we already had songs in the library. So and we included all of that in the unit. So Knock on Wood, Green Onions, Time is Tight, Hip Hugger, Soul Man, Try a Little Tenderness, Mr. Big Stuff were all done prior to this. So those all have links directly to the Jam Room. But if you're looking for all that material in general, in the upper right-hand corner of every page on Pulse are the icons for the various rooms. So if I click on the Jam Room, let's open that up in a new tab. I just go back here. And this is where you'll find all of the songs on Pulse, including the ones we added from the movie. And then just very quickly, I want to show you a couple last things. More Pulse materials, just a few things if you want to teach, if you want to use this material to teach about form, or we have an improvisation unit on the blues, there's some links there. You can go right to those pages and do sort of an extended, some extended teaching on those things, and a little thing on performance, like if you're in a band, just some things about how to be in a band, that sort of thing. And then last, so if you just want to show the movie clips but don't want to go digging around the site, we made that very easy to do under the last related Pulse activity, related movie clips, and it just shows all of the movie clips one after the other. And that's it.
Fantastic. John, if we could switch back to camera so that both those that are viewing are seeing Crystal, you, and me again. And I'm going to transition next to a question for Dr. Banfield. Could you tell us a little bit about, we engaged a friend, a close friend of the college, to author the materials from the Shelby County Schools. Could you did we talk about him? I think, just give let's give a little bit of background on our special expert who helped author the content.
Yeah, sure. We were really fortunate to recruit the person who is the director for Fine Arts and Curriculum Instruction, Dr. Drew Davison from Memphis Public Schools, the Shelby County School District. And he was incredibly enthusiastic about this. Of course, this being his heritage, which is a real treat for us because he was able to bring a level of authenticity to the materials and a level of depth based on his expertise that we all now have available for everyone. He presented in New York with us and was very engaging, and we'll have some clips. I understand we have something workshopping based on some of what he talked to the teachers about, but really the essence of his conversation reminded us about, keeping everybody at that discovery level of how do you do that? How do you excite your young people? How do you continue to inspire, help to inspire your emerging artists. What do you do? How do you engage yourself and also that's reciprocal when you yourself as a teaching artist, teacher if you will, are inspired and you go back and forth and exchanging ideas and mentoring your young people. And that was instilled in what he has provided for us. And he's encouraged and wants to do more work, so I'm looking forward on even more to come. One of the things that we're planning on doing is to continue to build this out. So there's such a rich history, as you'll catch in the opening clip of the movie. So we expect that we're going to have even more to come with respect to the R&B unit.
John, a question for you. One of the viewers asked, how long will the Take Me to the River content be available in Pulse? Is it limited, or will it continue to live there for a while? And then second part is, what do you think will come up next?
In your production? So the course material will live on, I think, indefinitely. And I think one of the plans we sort of talked about is that being just one aspect of perhaps a greater unit on the blues. And I think that's a really great goal to have, considering it's such a, major part of American music. What was the second question?
What's the next
thing? The next thing.
Everybody that's viewing is curious because they're loving the fact that the tunes from the soundtrack are available.
Right.
Do you have a favorite, or what do you think you and the team will work on next?
Well, we got the two. Well, they're all favorites.
You've been saying them.
Oh, yeah. Davis is my new middle name, but so Knock on Wood will be next. We're working on it. It's sort of up there right now, but we haven't completely transcribed it. We did a quick rush version because William Bell was at the New York City PD Day and was going to perform it. So it's up there, but we're going to have the complete version up there maybe in a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
I have to actually contact the person who's working on it. So, and then I think we just need to reconnect with Concord. We haven't officially, we know what we want, now we just have to get it.
Yeah, and they've been incredibly supportive and generous with this with this project.
Right. And they say, what do you want? And I say, all of it. So,
well, of course.
Of course.
Another question, folks are curious, there are some folks viewing today that don't have direct access to Pulse, so if there are folks here and they want to go check out a little bit or maybe get access to some of this content in a demonstration account, John, could you tell everybody where that's viewing where they should go do that?
Right. I think, was Amanda going to show something?
At the end?
Yeah, I think Amanda's going to show something at the end. pulsehealth@berkeley.edu, I think. Here it comes up.
Uh-oh.
I don't know.
Just switch back to your screen.
Oh, okay.
My calendar telling us.
Oh, never mind.
That we're down to less than 15 minutes to wrap up.
That's right. So I think we're going to have that information for you at the end. If not, we'll make sure that we say what it is. So for those who are just demo, not part of the network, basically we've been offering, you know, a two-month opportunity to use the material. If you're part of the network, obviously you'd be able to use the material for as long as you'd like.
And to Dr. Banfield, Crystal, the question, John mentioned earlier the vocal arrangement, Wish I Had Answered, and I know you were the point person here in the team who worked on the commission and with the arrangers. Can you tell our audience a little bit about, you know, for what voices is this appropriate and ways that they, because they'll be able to, those of you who are viewing will be able to find that arrangement both at Pulse and at the Filmmakers Education site. So it's freely available to folks that compliments of Berkeley. Can you share a little bit about that?
Sure, sure.
I'm going to close the
The commission that we've been talking about is Wish I Had Answered. We thought, wow, this would be a wonderful experience for youth choir. So the commission is written for young voices, and it's a very simple kind of call and response basic form, but it is intended for solo voice. If you have a strong student who can sing it, or anybody, you can, they can even speak through the parts. And then there's the choral part, and we've gotten two parts, one for soprano, alto, and tenor, depending on what your forces are. And then if you have some older students who are in the group and can sing bass, then we also have bass. And then it's also for rhythm section as well, and then which includes, of course, guitar, drums, bass, and keyboard. So it's something that is flexible and easy to do. We actually premiered the piece with a choir called Music Unites at PS 153, and this was an incredible choir of middle school students, and they were so enthusiastic. They learned the piece. I tell you, they learned it just in a few rehearsals. They had maybe, 10 days, and they learned the piece, premiered it, sang it a few times, even went through a whole instruction to get all of us old adults in the audience singing, and they had movements and everything, you know, so it was a wonderful piece for young people, and we're looking forward to actually doing a full premiere tomorrow night at the Apollo, so right. That's going to be great. The kids are going to come back again, and we're going to be joined with high school choir.
And if I'm not mistaken, we're going to have the performance from the professional day on Pulse at some point.
So oh, yes. Yeah.
Yes, everybody, keep your eyes peeled to both Pulse and I think to the to our social media channels for Berkeley City Music. One of the additional question here, we'll take just I think two more, and then we'll make our way on to sort of closing up and letting all of you know how to learn more and find out more. John, I think that for folks who have access to Pulse, they'll be able to log in and find a good bit of additional supporting material like you mentioned. Right. Where will they find that based on what you showed them earlier today?
Well, I think the place to go to is in the course itself. Do you want me to switch back to the screen?
Yeah, just briefly.
Okay. Here we go. We'll get there.
Oh,
here we are.
And while John's setting that up, folks, remember to find Pulse. It's berkeleypulse.net. So Berkeley, B-E-R-K-L-E-E, Pulse, P-U-L-S-E.net.
Right. So I think the best place to go is both in the notation mixers and sheet music, when you look at it, that is the whole section, really. The sheet music has all of the tunes that are related to stats. There's the extended learning matrix. And then the more Pulse resources, you know, just we have material on form, particularly blues form, since this music is mostly blues-based. We pretty much just put in the material that was related to the blues in this regard. But also, if you just go up into the Pulse Index at the top, I'll just click on Pulse Index, and if you search for blues, and there's some additional information on blues itself. So it's just one of many ways that you can sort of get around Pulse and find this material.
Fantastic. And if we can go back to camera, last question for today. I'm going to direct this at Crystal Banfield. Question from one of our viewers. If teachers have ideas for lesson plans or activities to complement what we were talking about with the Take Me to the River Pulse partnership, any thoughts, or are we looking for folks to share, Crystal, John?
Oh, yeah.
I figured.
Please send them. This one thing about this music is that it's universal, and it's intended to touch people. So if you have ideas, by all means, please send them to us so that we can share. More the merrier.
And John, if we share them, where will folks find them later?
You could put them right on the course. Well, I think it... Now I'm getting technical. I do that. Depending on what it is, you know, we can put it right in the course.
Great.
We'll find ways to put it right in the course. Maybe create an extra button that says, you know, teacher shared material.
Also, I'm going to take it a step further. They don't know what I'm going to say. I was going to just say, if you have a wonderful clip of your students, please send it to us.
Oh, yeah.
We would love to post it.
Definitely.
You know, of an actual, you know, live teaching or something of some of the music. It would be great to be able to share that as well. If you have some teaching examples too, please send those on.
Thank you. Well, we're coming up at the end of our time today. A couple of things that we want to share. Again, this was the first in what could be a series of webinars like these, where we can share information about what's in Pulse, what's new in Pulse. This will be, with Take Me to the River, the first of several new developments in Pulse that we'll want to share with you. So feel free to reach out to us or post on social media. This Google Hangout on Air will be available on our YouTube channel for Berkeley City Music. Also, for those of you who are in the New York City area, feel free to contact us in that, and you can write to pulsehelp@berkeley.edu. That's pulsehelp, P-U-L-S-E, help, at berkeley.edu. We can share with you how to find out more about the event that's happening at the Apollo. We've got a Berkeley City Music Ensemble from the South Bronx, from the Renaissance Music Center, performing. Our partner in Berkeley City Music, the Stax Academy, will be contributing performers to a band. The Memphis Horns are going to be there. This is a 7:30 downbeat. Show starts at 7:30. It is educationally focused, and there'll be some amazing music happening on stage, including the world premiere of in a public
wish I had, yes, wish I had answered. And we're going to expect all who come to sing.
So we'd love to have you at the Apollo for that. I know I can't wait. It's going to be super exciting. So do feel free to email us if you have questions. Feel free to email if you'd like to get some support in finding these resources in Pulse. We're very happy to share. If you're in New York, please join us at the Apollo tomorrow night. If not, stay tuned to our social media channels, including our Twitter feed, because we will share more information about what's happening with Martin Shore, the filmmaker's education initiative around Take Me to the River. So, Crystal, did I forget anything? Anything else you'd like to share for tonight, or John?
No, I think we're good. If you have any questions, you know where we are.
Well, this is terrific. I really enjoyed doing this session with the two of you. We'll be sharing more. Thank you, everybody, for joining today. It's been a real pleasure. Check out the content on Pulse. When you get a chance, keep an eye open for the film. Get it in your classroom. It's really a wonderful, wonderful learning experience to share, and a piece of art to share with your students and your community. So thanks, everybody. Have a great rest of the day, and we'll look forward to catching up with all of you again soon. Bye from Berkeley and Boston.
Bye.
Catch you soon.